He's now with Governor Scott Walker.
Kent.
Yeah, I am. The governor is joining me now. Just wrapped up the debate here. Governor, thanks for taking the time to talk with us.
Good to be with you.
Let me get your assessment, first of all, on how this played out.
Well, it felt good. You know, Mike's always very fair, so it gave us a chance to kind of push back a little bit, point out, you know, we've got a plan. We've got a positive plan to move the state forward. Time and time again tonight, I point out the mayor really doesn't have one, and I think that's why he's pushed so much the attacks on us. Our reforms are working. We've created more jobs in the state, more than 30,000, and then we got a chance to tell that story.
A lot of disagreement between the two of you, a lot of disputes over numbers. Anything that you would consider misinformation that voters came away with tonight?
Well, I think it's clear. I mean, people look at the job numbers. Even the federal government now has confirmed. They've reviewed the numbers. They revised them. They actually revised them up to 23,608. That means since I've taken office, there's been more than 30,000 new jobs. That's everyone agrees with that other than the mayor. And so I think that's probably the most important thing that came out tonight. Look at the facts. Look at the details. Every level, it's been validated. I think the other clear thing is we've got a plan to move the state forward.
He continues to hit you on the John Doe investigation. You seem to imply that was a cheap shot on his part.
Well, I think every time details have come out about the facts, it's clearly shown that what we've said is accurate. And I think when you think about the recall, I think for a lot of viewers out there, they say, what was this recall election about? It was about our reforms. Let's debate those. I'm proud to talk about the positive effects of our reforms. $1 billion worth of saving, property taxes down, state surplus, and now 35,000 plus jobs in the state. Those are all great things out there, and I gladly talk about that in comparison to what I think is a record of failure in the city of Milwaukee.
Well, you've talked about the mayor's record. You've talked about the fact that he won't answer the questions on the budget and his plan. Talk about what you think will happen if Mayor Barrett wins this election on Tuesday.
Well, again, he hasn't laid it out, but when he talks about it, he's had a $3.6 billion budget deficit, and he hasn't given an answer how. In fact, tonight he implied that the tax incentives for employers was a lot bigger than it really is. That's out over 10 years. He still would have had to come up with $3.6 billion. If we look at his record here in Milwaukee, it would have been higher taxes and fees, 43% increase in taxes and fees in this community. That's why unemployment, sadly, is up 28%. I think that's the contrast. Voters should look at his record, not just what he's saying, but look at what's actually happened. In our case, the record is unemployment is down 6.7%, the lowest it's been since 2008. And today on the front page of the Journal Sentinel, it talked about how the hiring outlook is bullish. Employers are excited about what we're doing. They're excited about the direction we're taking. They just want to make sure that that continues after June 5th, and that's why I'm asking for people's vote.
Let me ask you about one last thing, and that is probably the most heated exchange during this debate involved an ad that your campaign has been running that the mayor says involves a dead baby, and that he said you should be ashamed of running that ad. What's your take on it?
Well, again, the mayor brought the issue up. He brought this up in the primary. He brought it up in his State of the City address. He brought it up when he was running for election as mayor earlier this year. He claimed that violent crime had gone down. The point of that ad and our point overall is that the Journal Sentinel's investigative team found that with the sample they got their hands on, that violent crime is not down in the city of Milwaukee. Sadly, having a home just a few blocks from the city of Milwaukee, sadly, I wish it was down, but it's not. And what we've asked the mayor to do tonight, yet again, is to allow the city of Milwaukee to give the rest of those reports that the investigative team would like to see to really know what's happening to violent crime in the city of Milwaukee. I think voters deserve to know that. It was good enough to say that he should be, that was a basis for electing him when he thought it was down. I think it's obvious the other way around. If it's up, violent crime is up, as we now know it is, voters have a right to know what's up with that as well.
Governor Walker, thanks very much for taking the time. We appreciate it. Thank you very much. Governor Scott Walker, we just wrapped up. Mayor Tom Barrett standing by. We expect him to step in here just a moment to talk with us. In fact, I see him moving this way right now. If you can stick with us, the mayor should be making his way over here. We'll get his take on how this all played out here this evening. And here he is, Mayor Tom Barrett. Thank you very much for joining us. I appreciate you taking a few minutes. Let me ask you, first of all, about your take on this, how it all played out this evening.
Well, we were very pleased, obviously, and I think there were a lot of people who could see there's some stark differences. And I think people were struck by the fact that he continues to avoid any questions pertaining to the criminal investigation that's swirling around his administration. And as we saw in the report earlier today, even the district attorney felt that it was necessary to start this criminal investigation because they were not getting the cooperation that was needed from his office. So despite what he said tonight, the district attorney's office and the very prosecutor himself opened up this investigation because Scott Walker was not cooperating in the fashion that he thought was appropriate.
You've accused him of not answering those questions. He fired back by accusing you of not answering questions about your plan for the budget, what you would have done differently if you had been in the governor's office.
And I answered the question by saying that I would not have begun that conversation by having a $2.3 billion tax cut that would benefit corporations and the wealthiest people in the state. And I would not have then cut education by $1.6 billion. But instead, what I would have done is I would have brought people together rather than trying to divide and conquer this state. I would have brought local government. I would have brought state government. I would have brought businesses together and said, look, we've got a problem here, and we're going to have to work together, and there's a need to have shared sacrifice. But as I pointed out, he never tried to have shared sacrifice. Instead, what he tried to do was to punish his political enemies. And that's not the way you solve a crisis.
You said tonight that you stand by the job numbers that show Wisconsin losing jobs last year, that you weren't convinced by the Bureau of Labor Statistics verifying the job growth in the state last year.
Well, what happened was the Bureau of Labor Statistics put out some numbers, and Tom Barrett never put out any numbers. I don't have any numbers. Those are Bureau of Labor Statistics numbers, and he has shown me no reason that I should not accept those numbers. What he did 20 days before the election was trotted out some different numbers. Now he's claiming that an email exchange constitutes verification of that, but just today the federal government said that that's not verification, and he knows that those numbers cannot be verified until after the election. So it really comes back to the issue of trust.
Let me ask you about a very pointed attack that you made at the governor involving an ad that he has started running, an ad that you said he should be ashamed of, but it points to questions about Milwaukee's crime stat reporting.
Well, what he did is he's run a commercial that shows a dead baby, and the person who killed that baby was arrested by the Milwaukee police and was prosecuted by the district attorney's office. And there apparently was an error where the officer who filled out the report did not change a code. And he's using that to attack me and to attack the city. And I'm very, very strong in saying, look, if you have any evidence whatsoever that I have been involved in anything, then you better say it. But otherwise, shame on him for running that ad.
So you believe the ad crossed the line. What about just raising the question of the fact that you've been touting a drop in violent crime, and now there's some question about whether or not those numbers are accurate?
I stand by the numbers. For example, with violent crime, when you talk about violent crime, what comes to mind immediately is homicide. And we have seen a sharp decrease in homicides in the city, and I'm proud of that. And what I said tonight was that I've got a police department that arrests felons, and he has a record of hiring them.
Mayor, listen, I appreciate you taking the time and a few minutes to talk to us after this
debate.
I appreciate it. Mayor Tom Barrett, Governor Walker, both stopping by here just as they are about to head out of the debate hall after a lively debate here on the Marquette campus. Reporting live from inside Eckstein Hall on the Marquette University campus, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.